Hi, welcome to the next section, Concurrent Programming Design. In this section, we will start by using atomic variables instead of synchronization and holding locks for as short a time as possible. Then we will learn to delegate the management of threads to executors and take precautions using lazy initialization. At the end, we will learn to use the fork join framework instead of executors, avoid the use of blocking operations inside a lock, and use streams to process big datasets. Here we've included some suggestions to help you take correct design decisions which would make your concurrent application better. Now we move on to the first video of this section that deals with using atomic variables instead of synchronization. In this video, we will develop an example that shows how an atomic attribute provides better performance than synchronization. When you have to share data between multiple threads, you have to protect access to that piece of data using a synchronization mechanism. You can use the synchronized keyword in the declaration of the method that modifies the data so that only one thread can modify data at a time. Another possibility is the utilization of a lock class to create a critical section with instructions that modify data. Since version 5, Java includes atomic variables. When a thread is doing an operation with an atomic variable, the implementation of the class includes a mechanism to check that the operation is done in one step. Basically, the operation gets the value of the variable, changes the value in the local variable, and then tries to change the old value with the new one. If the old value is still the same, it does the change. If not, the method begins the operation again. Java provides these four types of atomic variables: atomic boolean, atomic integer, atomic long, and atomic reference. In some cases, Java's atomic variables offer a better performance than solutions based on synchronization mechanisms. Some classes of the java.util.concurrent package use atomic variables instead of synchronization. Let's start by creating a new Java project. Give it a name of your choice. I have already created one. Now create a class named TaskAtomic and specify that it implements the runnable interface. Import the Java library atomicInteger. Declare a private atomicInteger attribute named number. Next, implement the constructor of the class. Also, initialize its attributes. After this, implement the run method. In a loop with 1 million steps, assign the number of steps to the atomic attribute as a value using the set method. Now let's create a class named TaskLock and specify that it implements the runnable interface. Import these Java libraries. Within this class, declare a private int attribute named number and a private lock attribute named lock. Then implement the constructor of the class. Also, initialize its attributes. Post that, implement the run method in a loop with 1 million steps. You have to get the lock before the assignment and release it after. Now assign the number of the steps to the integer attribute. Also, we need to release the lock. Done. Let's implement the main class of the example by creating a class named main and adding the main method to it. Import these Java libraries and class. Create a task atomic object named atomicTask. Next, create a task lock object named lockTask. Declare the number of threads and create an array of thread objects to store the threads. Also, we declare the date attributes, begin and end. Now let's add the next block of code. Here, we launch the specified number of threads to execute the task lock object. Calculate and write its execution time in the console. Similarly, we launch the specified number of threads to execute the task atomic object. Here we calculate and write its execution time in the console. We are all set to execute this example, so let's do it. You can see how the execution time of the task atomic tasks that uses atomic variables are always better than the task lock tasks that use locks. You will obtain a similar result if you use the synchronized keyword instead of locks. The conclusion of this video is that the utilization of atomic variables will give you better performance than other synchronization methods. If you don't have an atomic type that fits your needs, maybe you can try to implement your own atomic type. In this video, we have learned to use atomic variables instead of synchronization.